The earth is warming up, and yet we're experiencing cold snaps in various parts of the globe. How is that possible? Since the 20th century, and most notably since the late 1970s, the globe has experienced an upward temperature trend that directly corresponds to the quantity of carbon dioxide that has been observed in the atmosphere due to fossil fuel emissions since the Industrial Revolution. This increase in the average global temperature is what we call global warming. The warmer atmosphere brought about by global warming triggers a shift in the normal climate pattern and leading to phenomena such as sea level rise, melting glaciers and ice sheets, and extreme weather events. This shift in the normal climate patterns is called climate change. And since this shift is brought about by global warming, which is primarily induced by human activities such as burning of fossil fuel, modern agriculture, and deforestation, it has been termed anthropogenic climate change by climate scientists. Anthropogenic here meaning human induced. It is quite easy to understand how a warming earth can lead to sea level rise. Of course, when temperature rises, ice will melt and thermal expansion of water will occur. Therefore, a combination of melting polar ice and thermal expansion of seawater would lead to a rise in sea level. Global warming has been said to influence extreme weather events like drought, flooding, storms, heat waves, and cold snaps. Global warming doesn't create these new weather events, but rather increases the risks we face by making our drought stronger, our heat waves more frequent, and increasing the amount of water vapor in the atmosphere. Therefore, when storms sweep through, which they normally would, they will have more water to pick up and dump on us as rain, thereby leading to flooding. In drought-prone areas, faster evaporation will occur due to increased temperature, thereby drying out their soils, lakes, and reservoir, which will lead to stronger and long-lasting drought when it finally occurs. So how exactly does global warming influence extreme cold weather conditions? As the earth is warming up, the Arctic is warming so much faster than the mid-latitude. Why? As the Arctic warms, the polar ice sheet melts, leaving dark open water in its place. This dark water absorbs more of the sun's heat, making the Arctic warm even faster. This leads to the narrowing of the temperature gradient between the Arctic and the mid-latitude. The temperature difference between the Arctic and the mid-latitude is very important because it drives the jet streams. The jet streams are a narrow band of strong winds high up in the atmosphere that normally pushes our weather systems along. As the temperature difference decreases, scientists suspect that the jet stream begins to slow down and meander. A slower jet stream makes our weather system less predictable. With wavier jet stream, there's also concern that the polar vortex might be pulled further south during winter. The polar vortex is a large area of low pressure and cold air over the Earth's north and south poles. When the jet stream weakens, it becomes wavier, allowing cold air to dip southward in some places as warmer air pushes up northward in other places. This can explain why cold snaps can be experienced in North America and Europe, while Australia would be experiencing extreme heat waves. I know some of us may get confused in the use of languages such as jet stream, temperature gradient, and polar vortex. So this is why I have brought this illustration done by Dr. Thomas Cohen on how warming can actually lead to cold.
It's painfully easy to demonstrate how global warming could make things colder, as I used to do during those years when I was teaching undergraduate classes at Mercy College in New York, when we had the famous polar vortex, and it brought snow in the late spring. I would simply have one student hold an ice tray over the head of another, and have a third hold a blow dryer. I would say to the student under the ice tray, "You are New York in the late spring. The ice tray is the polar ice in the Arctic Circle above us. The blow dryer heat is the increased temperature of an ever-warming Earth. Now, turn on the blow dryer and see how long you stay warm under the ice tray." Everybody got the point immediately, especially the kid who got cold water dumped on him in a visceral way. Now that's using your head.
I hope we now all understand the mechanism behind global warming leading to extreme cold weather. Thanks for watching my channel and please do subscribe. Bye and see you in my next video.